Good evening. As of around 1 minute ago, Sydney's light lockdown has become a full emergency shutdown, and it's not likely to end soon. The Delta strain is running out of control, but authorities deny their softly approach has cost us 44 new cases, another unwanted record, the worst day of the outbreak so far. 29 of them were not fully isolated while infectious. So what is this hard lockdown? The new rules are significantly harsher, slashing group numbers and restricting your movement to your local community. We will break down exactly what it means for you. It is all because of the speed of the spread. There are now new cases in almost all corners of Sydney, south of the Harbour Bridge, and there are more people in our hospitals, with 10 in intensive care, including a patient in their 20s. Ursula Hager begins our coverage.
From Manly to Bondi, the city to the southwest, the streets are all but empty, but it's already too late.
New South Wales is facing the biggest challenge we have faced since the pandemic started.
At the moment, we have over 14,000 close contacts. Now, yesterday it was 7,000.
The reason of the 44 cases today, 29 were not in isolation. It's meant major supermarkets, post offices and IKEA Tempe have been added to the list of exposure sites.
It tells us that in the next few days, those numbers are going to go up.
As a result, lockdown as we knew it is over.
Please do not leave your house, do not leave your home unless you absolutely have to.
From now, Greater Sydney, the Blue Mountains, the Central Coast, Wollongong and Shell Harbour are being placed into a hard lockdown. Residents must stay within their local government area and not go more than 10 kilometres from home for exercise. Outdoor gatherings are limited to 2 people. Only 1 person per household per day can shop for the essentials. And from Sunday, funerals are limited to 10 people in total.
Funeral directors are moving their funerals from Monday to tomorrow in order to have 100 people. Well, this is a person they've loved and cherished all their life, and not to be there, I can't even describe it. It's horrifying.
Adding to the woes, new cases aren't just in one area. 21 of today's cases are in the southwest, but there's also 8 cases in the southeast and 7 in Western Sydney. They're warning where the cases go, so will the police, to ensure compliance.
It's scary for everyone. They don't know what to do. It's all new. No one's been through this before.
Childcare remains open, but it's put the return date of face-to-face learning in schools in doubt.
I can't really comment on what school might look like until we get more information and more data on where the numbers are heading.
But retail stores still aren't being forced to close. This was Westfield Bondi today. Curiously, the advice is...
No browsing, only essential shopping.
Close those retail shops, require masks all the time. Otherwise, there's a much greater chance that the lockdown is just going to have to be extended.
So what has gone wrong? While the Delta strain is moving faster than authorities have seen before, they say the biggest issue here is compliance. The chief health officer says pictures like these from other countries may be part of the problem.
That is very different from our situation. We have only got 9% vaccination coverage.
For now, the mass hubs are being brought online. This one in Lake Macquarie will open its doors on July 19th, but supply isn't keeping up.
We need the vaccine.
Until then, there's only one way out of this.
Well, Ursula Hager joins me now on the desk. Ursula, that date of July the 16th to end the lockdown not looking too likely at the moment.
Well, Hugh, essentially no. These numbers are going in the wrong direction and there are still far too many people out and about while infectious. The Premier had been facing pressure even from within her own cabinet. At least one minister who hadn't want to see this lockdown continue, essentially due to the economic damage that it's causing. Gladys Berejiklian says on that front, they will be announcing new measures to support individuals and businesses within days, but there is no living with the Delta strain. It is simply too dangerous, Hugh.
Okay, Ursula, thank you. That danger is becoming clearer now in our hospital wards. Let's go to Taylor Ryan now. Taylor, a sharp rise today in people in ICU.
Yes, Hugh, sadly, as we've seen those COVID case numbers continue to rise this week, so too has the number of people winding up in our hospital system. As it stands at the moment, 439 people in our state do have the virus, and sadly, 43 of those are currently in hospital. So that's a hospitalisation rate of roughly 10%. Now, unfortunately, 10 people right now are in intensive care, and that includes a patient in their 20s and another in their 30s. It's numbers like this that have the Premier and Chief Health Officer very worried for the days and weeks to come. The Premier today indicating that the hospital system is on standby and will be able to cope should the situation worsen.
But at the beginning of the pandemic, New South Wales quadrupled its capacity to hospitalise people who might need ICU or need to be in hospital because of COVID. So the capacity is there, but I don't want us to have to go to that. I don't want to subject thousands of people to that scenario. It is not a pretty picture.
It's certainly not an image that anyone in our state wants to see us get to. The best way, of course, to avoid ending up here is to simply heed those warnings and stay home. And I think equally as important, Hugh, to get vaccinated if and when you can.
Best of luck to everyone in those hospitals. Thank you, Taylor.